Here are 7 simple ways to end your fear of public speaking in real life or on a webinar. I'm Peter Baker, and maybe you've been asked to do a talk at a conference or in a lecture theatre or something like that, or on a webinar where you're a guest or you've got to give a talk on a subject and you're absolutely scared. Now, I can understand why you are, because it's human nature. Many people don't like cameras, many people don't like people looking at them in an auditorium, and it's just natural to feel a bit nervous. So you come out for a nice country walk like this, get some air in your lungs, and oh, that'll make things better, won't it? Well, no, helps a bit, but look, stay with me on my country walk and I'll tell you 7 top tips. You don't even have to watch this video, you can download the free PDF, we won't even ask for your email address.
Tip 1. Speak often and regularly.
The funny thing is that people who don't like public speaking tend to avoid it. And if they avoid it, that means they're not doing it. And so by not doing it, they're getting out of the groove, you know? Every time they're forced to do some public speaking, they're starting again, you know, from square one, emotionally, certainly. So you need to do as much as you can to speak to people. Just use your voice. And you can do it in your hobby time as well. Maybe you've got a hobby that you've got a Facebook group. Do some Facebook Live videos. Do some videos on YouTube if you like. But just get into the groove of practicing again and again. Practice makes perfect.
Tip 2. Understand that people want to hear what you have to say.
You need to convince yourself, something which may be a bit obvious, but the reason you are giving your talk or are being interviewed on stage or on a webinar is because you know something that other people do not. And other people want to know that information from you. They don't care what you look like or any other thing about you. They just want that information. So you know something they don't have in their heads, and you are going to impart it to them. So surely that should give you confidence. So long as you've prepared the information well, got decent handouts or visuals on PowerPoint or whatever that are really clear and easy to understand, you won't have anything to worry about.
3. Make breathing your best friend.
It's human nature. When you're doing something out of your comfort zone, your palms will sweat, you will start to feel a bit nervous. It's all a part of an anxiety attack in a way. So this is what you need to do. Breathe. Just breathe. Nervousness is physiological, and you need to break this cycle by doing deep breathing exercises. And get into the habit of doing this regularly, not just before you go on stage or go on the webinar. By doing deep breathing exercises, your body will calm down before your mind, but one will cue the other. It really is worthwhile to learn some decent breathing exercises.
4. Start with a question or a story.
What's the most important part of a plane flight? Takeoff and landing. And it's just the same with a speech as well. Your takeoff is so important. The first things you say, don't just introduce yourself. Maybe that's already on a slide, on a screen or whatever. But start off with a question that everyone wants answering. Maybe an impossible to answer question. You see, you need to grab people right at the beginning. And ideally with a question or maybe a story. Everyone loves a story, an anecdote, something that ideally really happened to you. Start off with that, and that'll intrigue people, as well as giving you a nice, easy start. Learn that word for word, and that is your takeoff sorted.
5. Make it fun for you and for your audience.
Try not to think of the whole thing as a lecture. It's not. It's more of a conversation where you're doing most of the talking. Try and think of it like that. And try to simplify as much as possible. Don't use long or complicated words when simple ones will possibly do. Everyone in the audience is your friend. They want to hear what you say. You have nothing to worry about. The other thing to say is don't fear mistakes. If you slip up on something that's obvious, maybe a malapropism or you push the wrong button on the PowerPoint, look, don't worry about it. Just pass it off as something that happens to everybody. Use humor if you think it's going to work, and everyone will forgive you. Don't worry.
6. Don't be put off by audience reactions or hecklers.
We all want to imagine that every member of our audience is hanging on to our every word. Of course, if you're in a webinar, you can't see the audience generally. But if you're in a live situation, remember that everyone is different. You know, people are a varied bunch. and you may get people reacting in different ways to different stimuli. Now, you may get the person in the front row just looking at their shoes all the time. Looks like they're bored, but it might be the type of person who thinks better that way, so don't worry about it. You may see someone looking at the phone, well, that's just damn rude. But don't take anything like that personally. Just carry on and just have the knowledge that the majority of the people watching you want to hear what you have to say. Just continue. But here's a handy tip. If you feel that the audience is putting you off, don't look into their eyes. You can look generally in the direction of their eyes, wherever they are, but look past them. In other words, focus past them. So the people looking at you, it looks like you're looking at them, but you're not.
And tip 7, record yourself and play it back and watch your speed.
Finally, it's so important to practice, and you need to do that in front of a camera so you can see it back. If you haven't got a good friend who can do it for you, just set up your cell phone, put it on video record, and just do it. Don't do it in front of a mirror. You need to be able to look back at it on video to see how you speak. Maybe you speak too fast. Slow down. Maybe you speak too slow. Well, look, go to a speed which you think will engage the audience. You'll know the type of people in the audience, hopefully. The people who are interested in your subject matter. The people who maybe know about certain things and don't know about certain other things. So you'll know when to speed up and when to slow down for the important things. But you'll only know how you perform by recording it and playing it back. Now, I've just told you my top 7 tips, but there's plenty more to learn, especially if you want to be a confident presenter and take it to another level. So check out my course. I've been a presenter all my life, talking at conferences in front of hundreds, thousands of people, as well as being a BBC newscaster on TV, many radio stations as well. So please listen to what I have to say on the courses. Check out the link and see if it will work for you. I look forward to welcoming you on the inside.